In this episode of Hands On, we're going to figure out how to program a CCL3 using an ILP2 in Arduino. Okay, so let's look at the two chips here. The CCL3 is the same core, it's an ATSAM D21G18. Which is the same that sits in an Arduino Zero. And the IP02 here is the more advanced of the IP programmers we have. This one here can program all the cores we have. So there's two connectors on this one here. There's the normal bus connector, and then there's this little one here which provides USB. So when the switch in this IP02 is in a B position here, it actually takes the USB all the way through this connector and straight into this one here. If it's another position, it uses the built-in FTDI, the chip that sits underneath, and connect to those chips that programs using UART or Zero. But this programs using native USB, so therefore in that position here. The other one here is in the position for which way RX and TX works on a Zero. It's not important here because we're not using Zero. So let's look at a very simple example here. So here I have loaded Blink up, and up in tools I've chosen Arduino Zero, and we choose the native port. There's no programming port here. There's a native port only on the CCL3. And then we select the serial port, and when you plugged it in like that, so let me get back here. When you plugged it in here, you can see it comes up and suggests this serial port here. And it actually says that it have an Arduino native USB port sitting in the USB port. So that's the only thing to choose, these two informations here. So let's look at the code here. So the first thing we have to do is that this use a built-in LED that might not be the same as this one. So let's look at the wiki page. Okay, so here we go to the wiki CCL3. We just type in here. So if you type that in, then it automatically expands to the full name of the CCL3 here. So the CCL3 is our Cortex-M0 Plus core. It runs, as we mentioned, ATSAM D21G18. And if you look down on the page here, you can see there's some programming notes. So it actually explains exactly what we have to do here. So it says choose Arduino Zero. If you're using IP02, which we're using in this case here, then these are the settings. You can also use an IP03, and there's no switches on that, so that's straightforward. So in B, and I say here put in DCE, and it's simply just so if you plug anything else in, then it's always in the right position. Also, if you can't read the text here, the switches, both switches have to go to the same side. So that's easy to remember. Then we have some pin names. In the side, there's always the pin names, but they're like the native pin names, independent on what ID you use. So here, the pin names are what they've been called in Arduino. And then you also have to just remember, if you print to serial, this doesn't use the normal serial, FTDI serial. This uses the USB serial. So in Arduino, you use serial USB. So what you actually have to do is you have to write serial USB dot print line instead of just serial. But you can cheat by in the top say, every time I refer to serial, I actually mean serial USB. And then you don't have to change the code. I'm going to demonstrate that. But let's first look at some options here for switches here. So if we go back to our code here, then we have a built-in. So what I'm doing is instead of changing it all these different places, I'm just going to go in here and redefine what that value is. So we set it to A4. That was red. And then we press upload, and it goes through uploading. Try to find a port, find a port. It connects on the top of the screen, and it disconnects. when you do it this way here. And now it actually blinks red. So let's go back and look at the wiki. And we can see if you want to have it blink green, it's 8 and 9 is blue. So let's go back here, just change this to 8. Upload again. And now we have it blinking green. So let's take another example. Let's take one of the examples that comes with some of our sensors. So I have a sensor here. This is the weather sensor. So I'm not going to explain right now how we install the different libraries for the different sensors. That comes in another example here. It's all documented in GitHub on a wiki. But I just want to show an example when we start with the coding here. So I click that in. So now we have this connected, and I could have clicked into the side or wherever I want to here. So when you get your library for the different chips installed, then you will have some examples like you have with all the other ones. So we go down to the bottom here where XSW1 is, and we see, say we want to have a temperature. So here we have the temperature program. And what that does is that it prints out temperature, but it prints it out to the CL. So what you can do is you say define serial. It actually means serial USB. Okay. And then we have to, let's look at the program first here. It connects 115200 on the CL here. So we open CL monitor. I always do it first because I don't want to do it in the middle of the program or restart, and it automatically set to 115200. So what I do now, I just click upload. And then it starts. So here comes the temperatures. So it's 27 degrees here. In Fahrenheit, that's nearly 82.